The last thing we're going to talk about in MATLAB for Chapter 2 is scientific notation. Maybe it's not the last thing. The last thing I'm talking about today. MATLAB does not like to waste time showing you numbers it doesn't think you care about. So like the whole Avogadro's constant. If you just type this into MATLAB, you're going to get that. Wait, that's because I formatted bank. Oops. Do format by itself. That'll actually clear out the formatting, any formatting that you've done. And I'm going to go try this again. There we go. Did I spell Avogadro right? I have no idea. But anyway, it's 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. All right, so see the little E? That's not like the E that you get here. So like if I go to my little computer and I say, what is E? It's like, E is 2.71. I'm like, yay. Yeah. So E in MATLAB does not mean 2.71. E means times 10 to the. Is this what's actually written in your book? I wonder if that's in the new version of the book. Ha! It is what's in your That's funny. So, you see how it's got that little... Basically, what MATLAB is thinking is, wait, why are you trying to transpose Avogadro and then putting an S right next to it? That's not even... So, like, it actually would be totally happy, which is kind of funny. I'm not gonna mess with that. But like, if you actually put, like, a plus, you would get an error. Because it'd be like trying, well, if you hadn't defined Avogadro, but it'd be like trying to transpose Avogadro and then adding it to something called S constant. But at this point, it's just really unhappy. But anyway, there you go. If you type in the diameter of an iron atom, you get times 10 to the negative 10, 1.4 times 10 to the negative 10. So if you actually wanted to type in 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd, so I made my little section on scientific notation. If I wanted to do, I could actually type 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd and I get an answer, but I can also type 6.02 e to the 23rd. So I have x, y, and I get the same thing. So that's totally valid. Don't say 6.02 times e to the 23rd, or don't, I mean, there's all kinds of ways you can do this wrong, or, oops, I don't even think it likes it, yeah, it doesn't even like it if you have spaces, no, nope, that's, yep, that's the only way it likes it, so you have to do it that way, let's see, yes, makes you sad, all right, now if you actually wanted to raise E to some power, so like in college algebra, or in, engineering economics, if you wanted to say, you know, P e to the RT, so that's continuous compound interest, you could say, all right, P times e to the RT, but instead of saying E, you say EXP. EXP is what the little, so like this little E on my calculator, wherever it is, this little E, this E here is EXP in MATLAB. So this is a really big deal. So in MATLAB or in on a test, at some point, I'm gonna say, you know, write the code to get E squared. And you're gonna go E to the 2, and then I'm gonna count it wrong. Because E to the 2 actually has, I think it even gives you an error. In MATLAB, if you say E squared, it's like, what's E? And you're like, you used it like right here. And it says, I don't care, what's E? Like, oh man. So, if I want to know e squared, it's the exponential function squared. So, exp stands for the exponential function. So, it's the exponential function squared. So, if I just want to find the value of e, the exponential function to the first, all right, that's how I get it. All right, so that's something you really want to be sure that you've got. That's probably going to come up with the homework, definitely going to come up on the test, because that's an easy way to make sure that you're watching the lecture, is to ask you a question like that. All right, we should be good.